Earlier lectures on the haplogroups of the Y chromosome, non-recombining region of the Y chromosome. In the last film, I spoke about D haplogroup of the Y chromosome, and now I'll speak about C haplogroup and F haplogroup. Actually, we have in the YouTube the picture of the distribution of the F chromosome. Its time of origin or coalescence is about 50 kiloyears ago, 50,000 years ago. And you see, it's placed in northern India. My idea is it is wrong, because this haplogroup is the mother of all more recent chromosomes. And there must be an event in history of humankind which would correspond to such a explosion of the spread of the various types of groups of people. So, what could be this event? I'd say that if we speak about the time of about 50 kiloyears ago, 45 kiloyears ago, it's the Upper Paleolithic Revolution, which increased the productivity of the production of the stone tools tenfold. So my diagram, and this is, I think that the humanity would remember what I would show right now, is like this. This homeland of the F chromosome is situated not in India, but in the Levant. In the Levant, where 45 kiloyears ago the language was invented, the proto-human language from which originate all the human languages, all the 3,000 languages of the mankind which exist now. And by the methods of the glottochronology, I wouldn't explain now to the lay people what is glottochronology, but these calculations show the time of the origin as 45,000 years ago, 45 kiloyears ago. Actually, I think that it was invented by a woman, and she told old stories in this language to her son. But this is a special theme, and probably I'll touch upon this in some of the forthcoming films. But now, see, this is the F chromosome from which stem the daughter groups J, which stayed in the east, in the far east, in the near east, and at the same time split the I chromosome, which is the first chromosome in Europe, which is the chromosome of the people who came to Europe first 45 kiloyears ago and replaced Neanderthals. And actually, this scheme duplicates the scheme of the divergence of the languages. This is the F chromosome corresponds to the proto-human language, and then some people went to the east and some people went to the northwest and became the ancestors of the early Europeans, which were in turn replaced by the later Europeans. And these languages did not stay. You cannot even find traces of this Proto-European language now, because the only languages which are non-Indo-European in Europe are the Basque language or Finno-Ugrian languages, and these are much later newcomers to Europe. But this haplogroup K gives the offshoot of MS, which reached the New Guinea. So this is the group of people, males, who spoke the future Papuan languages, or the language family, which is called by Joseph Greenberg Indo-Pacific, which is represented mostly in New Guinea, but one language in Himalayan region probably some people think of that, belongs to the Indo-Pacific group and is related to the, specifically related to the Papuan languages. This language is called Kusunda. This is language of the people who live near the Himalayan ranges. I mean, south of the Himalayan ranges. And the last thing that I want to, by the way, this is the Russian chromosome group. This I is represented mostly, maybe 30%, of the Scandinavian people, because they are the more ancient in Europe. And this is the group of Russians, R, R I, R 1 A and R 1 B, but we came to Europe from the east. Now, and the Q, I think Q, I pronounced it correctly, this is the haplogroup of the American Indians, who from the Central Asia came to the America. And what I wanted also to tell, that this is, these haplogroups are the continental ones. The people bearing them, they spread across the plains of the Eurasia. But the first haplogroups of C, D, and E, they were the haplogroups of the beachcomber population, which moved along the coasts. And here, two of these first haplogroups stayed in Africa, A and B. A is represented among the Bushmen. And then the humanity, about 80 kilo years ago, crossed the Bab el Mandeb Strait, according to the view of Stephen Oppenheimer, which I agree with, much later than most people think that people came here from through Levant, but they came very earlier than the 100 kilo years ago, but later they became extinct. And the distribution of the mitochondrial chromosomes shows that the out of Africa way was southern, along the coast of the Arabian Peninsula. And these are the beachcomber haplogroups altogether, C, D, E, and F. And I spoke last time about the D haplogroup, which corresponds to the moving of the people along the Indus River Valley about 60 kilo years ago. But C, the C haplogroup, unites together, it is attested, in Mongols and in Australian Aboriginals. How can it be explained? Suppose that some early group of beachcombers reached the narrowest part of the Malaccan Peninsula, which is called the Isthmus Kra. And some people crossed this isthmus and went northeast along the coast till they reached the mouth of the Huang He River, and by the flow of this Huang He River, they reached Mongolia and Central Asia. But those who didn't cross had to travel south until finally they reached Australia. And this haplogroup also is represented in Oceania. But how could split, and how came the two beachcombers group, one of them came earlier and the other came later, and they went almost the same routes? I think that the fact that could explain this narrow part of the Persian Gulf. Suppose that this is the CF haplogroup, and some people who were DE, they crossed this strait, the narrow part of the Persian Gulf, and they went, some of them went along the coast and became D haplogroup, and some of them came in the opposite direction, E haplogroup, and finally reached Africa. So they came back to Africa. But those who didn't cross this CF, they had to go along the coast this way, until finally they reached the mouth of the Tigris and Euphrates rivers, and those who went along the rivers became Europeans finally, and those who went the same route as the bearers of the haplogroup D, they went some at least 5,000 years ago later, the same route, until they reached the Kra Peninsula. And this is all I want to talk about today. Thank you very much.